So this is one of the case study you could find online on the website. It used to be on the French website at the beginning, so this available only in French. And within the task 59, we bring it with other buildings, translate it to show these cases at the European scales, and we found it very interesting to share experiments with colleagues from other countries, and that's why I'm also very happy to be here. Hopefully, we will soon get the pictures. So, as I say, it's available online, and CREBA is the name of the French website. If you speak French, because for now it's not translated, you can find other cases available in France. And we continue to bring some. I think for now we have 15, and we want to raise this number in the future. So the cases I would like to present to you is a half timber house from 18th century in Schnersheim in Alsace, east of France. It's a very typical Alsatian vineyard residence. If you like white wine, it definitely is the place you want to go. It's not listed, but with a strong heritage interest, as you can guess seeing the picture. Here, the first one from 1 century ago, and then another one from the 60s. This is very typical farm with a very large, it's nearly 300 square meters large. And this used to be with the whole family, including several generations, in the same buildings. That's why in the past they are so large. We have a real problem in Alsace with this kind of buildings, because we have noticed that it's an average of 300 half-timbered houses that are destroyed each year. That's a lot. And I have an illustration here. And that's a problem because the new generation, when they inherit this kind of house, they don't exactly know what to do with it, because it's so large, it's so expensive to maintain, to eat, and it's not so easy to split and share as apartments. So we have a main problem is around the village, we have a lot of new construction, and in the village, we have all these kind of old buildings without anybody anymore. And after some times, municipalities want to do some things, and we could assist to some demolitions and new buildings. What we would like to do, of course, with several people involved, is saving this landscape for future generation, this Alsatian landscape, very typical, to ensure that people want to live in this kind of buildings. Not only tourists, because in touristic place, it's okay. You can make rooms to rent and it works. But in all the other villages without these touristic visits, we want people living these buildings and not wanted to build new at the end of the village. So bring energy performance, comfort, and light in this kind of buildings, because it's very large in square meters, but it could be quite dark with small windows, and the height between two floors could be quite small. So not exactly what most people look when they want to buy a house. The context of this retrofitting project, here you can see the house in the middle of the yards with the old technical barns and technical buildings. It's 20 kilometers from Strasbourg in a small village to 20 kilometers from Strasbourg. That means there is a very high value of the ground and a lot of pressure on the buildings. That's why in this kind of village, we assist usually to the demolition of the barns to build new house. But here we have the chance that it's quite homogeneous village with other typical farms from the same period, 18th century. So that's really worthy to keep a building like that. The new owner of the house, he has a global retrofitting project and is in the building construction himself. So he knows what he's doing and he has a strong idea of what to do. He wanted to show to the new generation that it's possible to be comfortable in this kind of house. He applied for a grant for exterior works related to heritage and also a grant for energy performance to the regions. This kind of grant from the region, you have to go below a certain energy consumption, which is 100 primary energy per square meter per year. And usually people think that with this kind of building, it's not possible. So there's very few demand. But he continue, and you will see that we reach it, and he gets the grant. Heritage consideration with these buildings. I mean, in the basement, we have this stone column with the date. 1770 for first house. And in 60 years later, we can have the date with dendrochronology analysis for the timber frame. Because, and it's something quite common at this time, the timber frame come from another house and have been rebuilt on the basement because we think that we have a fire in 1730 and then they have to look for another timber frame. And we have this document from the time that is the list of the wood to be provided to build the house. And the owner of the house would like to get this certification, Fondation du Patrimoine, that will give him something to be proud of, and also a bit of money for the project. It's a three-story attic, traditionally used to dry tobacco in the area. That's why the roof is so large. And with this typical U-shape, so a very interesting project. The works begin in 2010 with the retrofitting project and with the removal of the oil tank in the basement. Because in the 60s, fuel boiler has been installed, and then we have to remove everything. The house was in poor condition. It looks, when we look at it, it looks okay, but in fact, and we'll see that we have a basement very humid due to a concrete floor from the 70s and cement coatings on the walls. So we could simplify it in bad renovation in the 70s on this house. And there is damage. We have a differential settlement, 12 centimeters, below a large stone load-bearing wall, the brand one. It's the big stone wall close to the kitchen and to prevent fire from spreading on the wood structure. So we have to remove this wall because it was in a very bad shape, and the horizontal main fir timbers, the sablier, on the first floor needed to be replaced. We can see it on the picture here. And I was quite happy to have the presentation this morning about craftsmanship, and we have this chance in Alsace to still have some craftsmanship to do this kind of works here. And it's a day-to-day fight to keep them. And it's not, so I'm quite happy about this new project funded by the European Commission. I think we need more of that. So project begin by the windows. This is typical from a bad exchange with heritage architect, because in 2012, the first one consulted, said, no, you don't change the window. I want to keep the single glass windows, this one, and you don't have the right to touch them. But after a lot of negotiation, in 1 year later, we managed to bring these windows. It's double glazing windows, but with design from the 18th century. This design is for the first part of the 20th century. So, and in the time, the architect changed at the city of Strasbourg. So depending on the heritage architect, we can do things, we can't do things. And it's something that is quite difficult in France for now, because that makes things difficult. The value of these new windows is 1.3. That's pretty good, not as good as new windows, but we have a result very convincing with oak and very high quality. This is a new basement of the house. It's not heated, so it's only used in spring and summer. And so it has been totally retrofitted in a historical point of view. The roof also, you can see, is a work in progress. And the owner used beaver tail tile. It's very typical from the place. And we have insulation on the attic floor. Here, some illustration of the insulation of the floor. And you see the first of the three-story attic. With all the first the air intensity membrane layers, then we have some oak pieces, and then the wood fiber boards on top of it. That's for the top floor. For the walls, we choose M concrete because M concrete we could put it inside the wood frames and also as a layer on the inside of the buildings. We could see it here. We add a U value of 0.4 for the wall. That is not as much as we can find usually in low consumption retrofitting, but it will be enough to reduce the consumption from drastically. For the floor, it's very interesting because you can see here that a double flux ventilation duct passed in the floor, and the M concrete was bring inside the floor. That's very interesting because usually in this kind of project, the ventilation is really a difficult thing to achieve. Especially in this kind of buildings, when we don't have so much place between two floors. We can't have pipes everywhere, and double flux ventilation is usually discarded. Here, we managed to do it because of the floor. The air permeability also, we arrive at N50 of 2.04. That's not so bad for this kind of house. We have problem because of the timber frame that move according to the season and the cob. And here, on the heated part of the house, we achieve a very nice air permeability with special focus on wood beam ends that usually are a problem with air infiltration that could lead to moisture problems. The staircase in the middle of the house is surrounded by glazing. That's allow to have a very nice air permeability around the place as the staircase go to the attic and go in the basement. The heating and the hot water. Heating is a new wood pellet boiler, with a good efficiency and a large silo equipped with an aspiration system. It's at the back of the basement. And we have also a traditional stove that I think we can also find here in Austria. And we still have some craftsmen to do this kind of work. So it's good to give them some jobs sometimes. That is also with wood. Domestic hot water in two storage tanks, and it's done with a pellet boiler. So we have a kind of renewable energy in shape of wood. I don't have a battery anymore. So the light, as I say in my introduction, the light could be a problem in this sort of house. So here, on the garden side of the house, we have chosen the solution of opening the fill between the wood frame to bring on the second floor some light in the main room. And we can see it in the shape of the loggia. That is to answer to the question, yes, we can do this kind of, we can do that. And as a heritage part of the house, it's okay, because when you are in the street or in the garden, you don't really realize, and it's quite well integrated in the rest of the work. Now, for the economic point of view, because it's a very important project, Concerning the energy retrofitting part only, it's 150 euro, 1,000 euro. So that means 440 euro per square meters without the window specifically made. I don't have the price of this window, but it could be quite expensive. Finally, there are some small grants for the owner, and we can see that maybe half of the price is for the system, HVAC systems, with a ventilation that is 15%, and the insulation with M concrete is not so expensive. And the owner of the house contributes to the work by doing all the preparation himself. So that also reduces the price. To add to these bills, there is also some restoration part on the outside of the house and in the attics, but we haven't put it on this slide because here is the price only for the energy retrofitting part. Finally, what is it to live in this house? It's 25 degrees maximum in summer, measured in the house, even when it's 36 outside, so that's pretty appreciable. 19 degrees everywhere, at least in winter, and 20 degrees in bathrooms. Before the project, we have a consumption bill that is 352 kilowatt hour per square meter for a year. And after the project, with the architect calculation, we would decrease to 94 kilowatt hour per square meter per year. And in 2017, we have measured 102 kilowatt hour per square meter per year for heating and hot water, for the wood pellet and the wood in the stove. That is approximately 2,500 euro for a year, but it's for 350 square meter. And there was also maintenance contract for the balanced ventilation and for the heating system that did not exist before, so that's something you have to pay after the retrofitting every year. So finally, we like a lot this project because it shows that this kind of not listing but very interesting building in terms of heritage could be very livable and very nice now with after all this work. For sure, it's expensive, but we could imagine for people that are not so as rich as these owners to live with his wife in 350 square meters, that we can easily separate this kind of house in two or three apartments, maybe four. And we have an action to encourage mayors in small villages to promote this kind of application for their old farms. In place of allowing people to build a lot outside their village, a new construction, we have place, we have these buildings, and we really would like to have them used for decades. Thank you.